Africa 2021. Tato Mosele, hi Tato, hi.
Hello,
How are
hi Adam.
you?
I'm fantastic, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. It's my first time to finally meet you in per e meet you. I'm so happy to be
Me
doing this.
Thank you for having me. I'm so grateful.
My gosh, you look so different now since your last crowning moment. The hair color. Look at the hair color.
Do you
It's
like it?
now, yes.
It's warmer. It matches my skin tone. Vapna suggested it, and I was like, But once I've put it on, I love it. Love
Is
it.
it for Miss Supranational?
Yes, this is the final look that I'm taking to Miss Supranational, and this is my
Oh.
hair for the final night. Yes.
So you're unveiling it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. So how are you since that fake mo since your winning moment in Miss South Africa last October?
I've been doing great. I literally grew in a short space. I think it's been 6 months. Yes, it's been 6 months.
Yes.
I've moved. I've completed my internship. I moved to Johannesburg, which is very central in South Africa, where a lot of the Miss South Africa activities are happening. So I've moved there and I've been keeping good. I've been living alone, but I've been keeping good.
Are you so used to the attention since
I
winning?
it's so funny because growing up, I usually used to say, I love attention. I love attention. Look at me. But then
Yes.
when it comes, at times it gets a little bit overwhelming. But I guess living alone helps you just reset, recuperate, because I do have control over my social media. So sometimes I do switch over sometimes, but I'm still good.
Yes. Speaking of that, I want to ask you, because you were a judge's first runner up, right? So
Yes.
how were you appointed as Miss Supranational? Did they just appoint you, or did you have a hand in getting your desired title, which is probably Miss Supranational? That's why you're here for a reason.
Okay, so what happened was the three of us were asked to sit down and to sort of think where we would want to go. And then I remember I entered Miss South Africa having heard of Miss Supranational for the first time. And I always said, this sounds like a very fun and exciting new pageant because I love new things. I love things that weren't done before. I love being the first to do many things. So I thought it would be great for me to try out Miss Supranational, even though people would expect me to go to Miss World or Miss Universe. I think there's someone like me would really bring something new to the pageant of Miss Supranational. That's what I want to. I want to make a real difference.
So I wonder if, let's say, I just want, thank God that you all three had different titles in mind, because I wonder if all three of you chose Miss Universe or Miss Supranational or Miss World. I think, how would you guys solve the dilemma? By drawing lots.
I don't know. I think we were so different that it just worked out. It really just worked out. And the organization obviously knows better. So they really came up with the technical reasons of why it makes sense. And it does make sense. Because South Africa is really strategic. We really put effort into each and every competition that we go for. So I think we made the right choices. I don't know, we'll see when we get there.
And look at you, in a few weeks' time, you'll be competing for the forthcoming Miss Supranational. So, how are you feeling right now?
It's such an honor. I feel so excited. Time has moved really quickly. It's literally in less than a month, I'll be flying to Poland. I've never been to Europe, so that's also an exciting aspect for it. The traveling of it, the experiencing different cultures, because South Africa is very diverse, and we're all about exploring each other's cultures. So I'm so excited to explore another culture, which is the Polish culture. And I get to travel during COVID, you know? We're still matching.
Beat that.
We are very much in South Africa, rather. We are in the third wave. So to sort of break away from that would also be good for me.
So have you gotten yourself vaccinated now?
Yes, I have. I was one of the first few people to get vaccinated. And I'm happy I did, because I'm feeling much more secure, comfortable. So hopefully the rest of the country can also get vaccinated and we can finally move past this. I just want to move past this.
Yes, yes, for sure. You know, you'll be in for a great time once you set foot in Poland. Oh my God, are you excited?
I am. I hope it's a very nice journey, because when I look back at my South Africa journey, we were so friendly with each other. We learned so much from each other. Some of my closest friends now I met in the pageant, and I'm hoping to get the same experience from the Supernational. I don't want it to be so tense and tough and serious, although it is at a much higher platform. I think we still shouldn't miss the opportunity to connect as human beings. And that's what I really love and look forward to.
That's nice. Yeah. So, you know what? I'm reading your bio right now, and you are a medical profession. You are a medical doctor by profession. Considering that you've just completed your internship this year, as you aspire to become an anesthesiologist, am I right?
Yes.
And now, placing so high in Miss South Africa last year, and now you're about to compete for Miss Supranational. I wonder, how do you reconcile both words, a doctor beauty queen at that?
I'm literally all about just, you know, tapping into your potential. I believe every single person should try out as many things as possible, because you never know what you're born with on the inside. So I come from a small town in South Africa, where being a doctor is literally, you have made it. You are, wow, you're incredible. You have broken so many barriers, and which is really nice to acknowledge. But what I want to set for myself is a standard that is not set by other people. So I don't just want to be a doctor who has done great things, but someone who really tapped into all her talents. So I'm the type of person to try out dancing, and I realize I suck, but I tried it, you know? I try out singing, I can't swim, but I try out things, because you never know what you're really good at and what you can make a difference in the world. So I try to balance being a beauty queen, aspiring to be a model. I am a part-time student for makeup, and I'm a doctor. But it's all about prioritizing on that day what's important. And if things are clashing, you need to select one. So for example, now I'm going to Miss Supranational. I've decided it would be unfair for my job to keep on asking for days off. So I've completely stopped that, and now I'm focusing on this. So it's all about what you're prioritizing at that time of your life to make sure that it gets done. That's for me. That's my motto.
Wait, I want to ask. So are you on an indefinite leave right now from work?
Yes, because I'm like, maybe I'll come back next month or in a year. I don't know.
Yeah, depending on the results of Miss Supranational. Yes.
Hopefully in a year.
So when did you realize you wanted to become a beauty queen?
I was actually really very sporty. I did a lot of athletics, netball in high school. I did provincially, and my aspiration was never to be a beauty pageant queen. In fact, it was to be an international athlete. I wanted to represent South Africa on the sports grounds. But when I enrolled into university my first year, I was so excited. I remember the day so clearly. We were trying out for the provincial netball team, and I made it into the team. But the first practice, I dislocated my kneecap. It sounded like a gunshot. So my kneecap got dislocated. And ever since then, my knee is very unstable to perform competitively in sports. So I just had to find something else to do. And I remember in the first year, the first pageant I did, it was a compulsory pageant for all the first years to do it. I dreaded it. But while I did it, it was so much fun. And I remember I came out, I wasn't even in the top six, but someone came to me and said, hey, do you know that you have potential to be Miss South Africa? And it was such a new concept. It wasn't from me, it was from someone else's observation of me, which is why I think it's very important to be careful how you say stuff to people. You can lift them up or you can bring them down. Because I'm forever grateful for that lady. Well, she was my senior who said to me, you could be Miss South Africa. Because I started considering that. And as I started doing pageants, I realized this is so possible. Yeah, maybe this is my path in life, not the sports route, but the pageant route. So I'm very happy.
And you've never regretted that decision since
never,
then?
Never, ever. I've had the best times of my life. I've made the best friends in pageantry. I've learned the best skills in pageantry. So I'll forever be grateful. My confidence, my ability to speak in front of anyone or converse with anyone has improved. So I'll forever be grateful.
You know, I wish your voice could be amplified around the world, considering that, especially in Western countries, people tend to look down at beauty pageants as irrelevant or very shallow. But there are contestants like you who really, you know, vouch for what a pageant can change someone's life, right? So yeah, I hope more people will get to recognize all the things that you have been doing as aspiring beauty queens, right?
I hope so. I hope they see not just me, but all the beauty queens that are really using this platform for significant change and to spread good messages.
Yes. And now you're also a medical doctor. And as a medical doctor, your profession is very much in the limelight nowadays, considering there is an ongoing pandemic, which we all haven't beaten yet. So how do you think the medical industry has been coping up with the health crisis right now? Are we going to see the end of this very soon?
I don't know very soon, but we'll definitely see the end of it. And we in South Africa, I can only speak from us, have been so overwhelmed. But I think it has just shown us our capabilities. I used to do athletics, so I love to use examples. You know the high jump effect? I used to like high jump.
Yes.
Wherever the bar is set, that is where you will jump. And that is where you learn that you can jump. So I think the pressure had been so high that we learned that, wow, we can actually be very resourceful. We can actually work under pressure. We can literally share ourselves to such an extent that to help people as far as we need to, you understand? So I'm just like, the medical professionals have learned so much about their strengths, even though the weaknesses were exposed, but we have learned about our resilience, our ability to keep awake, our ability to remain compassionate under pressure, to remain resourceful, to still be human beings at the end of the day, even under faces of adversities, which prepares us for, if at all, a next pandemic or any other crisis.
So is this the reason why you set up your own Tuesdays Talk Online show recently?
Yes, I've recently started that, which is going really well. I had to really do something that won't require me to interact with a lot of people due to social distancing and minimizing contact. So I just started from where I know. I just share information that I've learned that other people may have not. You know, sometimes you Google something and it confuses you more. So my aim is just to clarify certain things. I get suggestions from my viewers. I get suggestions from my seniors at work about things we see can be prevented that we see in the hospital. So it's very much preventative based, very much educational, but also very lighthearted and not too intense and easy to understand.
Yes. So what I caught one episode of it when you talk about HIV awareness. You know, it's very good that you have been, you know, you delve on that topic, considering that in third world countries where I come from, it's still I mean, the information is still not readily available, and the statistics, despite all these campaigns that we have been doing, are still going higher.
Yes.
Yeah.
But, and the stigma surrounding it is still very high. The stigma surrounding HIV and AIDS and the management thereof. So just to shed light on that, those kind of things that people won't readily look for, but they watch me every day so they could watch my Tuesday talk on a Tuesday.
I wonder, why did you call that Tuesday?
So Tuesday, just because I love how it sounds. And it's just and it's just like, just make the right choices for your health. So that's what it is. So you get to choose the right things for your own health. So having more control over your general state of health.
Nice. I thought it had something to do with the fact that probably Tuesday was only your day off. So that's where that's the only free day of the week that you can do your talk, online talk show. But you know, seriously now, do you think as a medical, I don't know if how you will answer this as a medical doctor or as a typical human being, but you know, do you think this pandemic has been teaching us something about ourselves, about life in general?
Yes.
For what you have learned, what you have learned from it?
For me, it's simple. It's just that you're always stronger than what you think you are. You're always more resilient than what you think you are. I've had COVID, and I've overcame. My mom had COVID and she overcame. And then there are those people who've had COVID and passed on. And those who are remaining, those who are remaining are still coping. You know, they are trying their best to still live day by day. There are people who have lost jobs and they are still fighting. And I think every day they keep reminding themselves, I am still fighting. Even though this is how it seems, we are stronger than what we think we are. So I think out of all of us, it has brought out our strengths and our abilities to overcome challenges.
So you think we will come out stronger and better than this?
Definitely. I think any challenge that you overcome will leave you stronger. If it kills you, it kills you. But if you overcome, you're definitely stronger.
Yes. And you know what, as I, you know, as I do my research for this interview, you know, I keep your answer during the Miss South Africa pageant, when I keep playing it over and over my head, especially with the way you answered or you nailed your question in top five, especially when you talk about the opportunities and setbacks in achieving a progressive South Africa, you talk about a common pain that all South Africans had to go through. So can you expound more of it?
When I say common pain, I mean a sense of loss. For the first time in South Africa, if you might know, had a lot of previous injustices in the past. There was a lot of setbacks for a certain population and other populations were advanced forward. So for the first time in South Africa, there was this virus that did not discriminate gender, did not discriminate age, did not discriminate socioeconomic status. It affected everyone. Everybody felt a sense of loss. Whether you lost your peace, you lost your health or your loved one, everybody lost something, you know? So I felt like for the first time, we could all feel one thing. And unfortunately, it is a negative thing, but it brought us together. Once I've felt something that you, Adam, have felt, you and I are more connected. And I think that's what happened.
Yes. And you know what? I also read an article recently about your country that the recent decision of the government to ban alcohol in public places hit an emotional chord on a lot of you guys. And yes, you guys are saying that it had something to do with your painful history. So can you connect me with that? Because I'm kind of like how does the alcohol ban had something to do with your past, with your painful past, with your country's painful past?
For me, I understand that alcohol has been negatively associated with the amount of trauma cases and lack of adhering to restrictions to COVID-19. And with the removal of alcohol, we have managed to relieve the pressure on hospitals because not so many people will come in because of alcohol-related injuries.
Yes.
And chances are, if you are sober, you are more likely to comply with restrictions. But as for it hitting a spot, I don't know, maybe there's a bit of dependency there, but economically, obviously, for people who deal alcohol, it has hit a spot, but I can't elaborate further than that.
Yeah, fair enough. But you know what? Since the start of this interview, and I've been watching a lot of your recent interviews, you are so well-spoken, no doubt, and very articulate. I wonder if you have role models that you look up to navigate you through the goals and your successes in life.
Definitely. I have to say my mother, although she's not eloquent or well-spoken as defined by society, she has a way of communication. She has a way of connecting with people. And I always want to leave that with people. I don't want us to just talk. I want you to actually feel what I'm saying, so that we connect. And academically, there's a doctor called Dr. Pashi Ntsane. She's in academia. She really came from the rurals of South Africa and managed to study her way to the top. And in combination with my mother, those women have taught me how powerful education can be, how always improving yourself can set you at an advantage to help others in the world. So I really value the power of education because of those two women.
Yes, and looking at your caliber right now, I'm really amazed. I think that level of education has what made Miss South Africa, the whole pageant system, very popular around the world, as it has been attracting high caliber women like you. So was it about Miss South Africa pageant that really draws girls like you to compete?
It's really just about the message they put out and the kind of girl they say they're looking for. They say they want an authentic woman. They don't want a model. They want a role model. So you just look at yourself and say, can I be a role model for other young girls in there? You know, you don't have to be a supermodel. Those things can change. I mean, you see, I've changed my hair. It's like nothing. But who I am and the kind of person I am is always going to be the same. And that's what draws women like me, I think. It's that essence of a good quality woman that needs to be replicated in our country and to be showcased in our country.
Yes, you know what? I'm more impressed with the Miss South Africa organization is your rules that tend to be lax, as you tend to accommodate more girls from different backgrounds, even if they don't have any South African blood, you know. Mm-hmm. And that's why every year I get to see, you know, look at these beauties. They're all very diverse. They look completely different from each other. Mm-hmm. Apart from the fact that you guys talk well, because us here in the Philippines, it's really important and it's really a must that you are, you know, you really have to prove your nationality, yeah, that you're mm-hmm. a Filipino. But in South Africa, I don't think it's a requirement, right?
No, you don't have to. There's no South African look. We are generic. We are welcoming. If you are on our soils, we accept you. And I think that's how every country should be. We should really accept the people living in it, whether they, because none of us know actually where anyone comes from, really, really. If we actually had to analyze that this is not your home, we would fight. So for whoever chooses to call this home, we should accept them and let them represent us, because that's really what you see. What you see in the top 10 of Miss South Africa, and I'm sure in the applicants of this year, everybody is so diverse, but that's what we see when we walk out in the streets. They really represent what we see on the streets.
I love your answer. It's very empowering.
Thank you.
Yes. You know, I as I have been saying, I hope that your voice will be grows your voices like yours should be kept amplified over and over again for all these feminist critics to hear. Cause you know, you guys have been taking a beating down with how, you know, pageants have been looked down. So what can you say to critics who say that pageants like Miss South Africa and now Miss Supranational are irrelevant considering the times that we are in right now?
I would literally just come to myself and say, look at me, look how I have grown beyond what people said I could, you know? I went in here, I was just, you know, a medical doctor, but now I was empowered. Funny story, I went into South Africa super nervous about being a doctor because I've only been doing it for 2 years, right? So I've always wanted to share my information, but I never felt like I was specialized enough to share that information because there are other more professional people who have studied this, like professors and stuff. So who am I to come and just share? And then the platform such as Miss South Africa allows you to really understand your power, really understand that you have a lot to offer, what you have is enough, and you shouldn't doubt yourself. So I'd say it really gives you, I don't see myself getting a confidence boost like that from any other institution, because you go to the workplace, there's still men who look down on women. You walk on the street, there's still men who catcall you for how you look. But you enter a pageant and you feel empowered as a woman, and not to dumb down who you are, but to really step into your light, really step into your power. So I love the slogan of Miss South Africa, face your power and embrace your future. You literally have to say, this is who I am, this is what I can do, and my future is this bright, whether you like it or not. And I can't see why people would criticize a platform that can do such for a woman.
Yes, and I'm very confident that that is what you're gonna bring in Poland very, very soon. Your very empowered self. So how are you preparing for the pageant right now?
Oh, a lot of the preparation. For me, my biggest insecurity is the walking part, because I never really know. So I'm practicing how to walk. I'm really having life coaching sessions. I'm working a lot closely with Berna. We are watching the previous pageant. We are seeing how the previous title holders have done it, not to copy, but to draw inspiration and really understand the brand. I am having a lot of fittings. I'm making a lot of outfits. And I'm really, really centering myself to be in the headspace of a winner. Because it doesn't help you look like a winner, but you get there and you don't believe that you are. So I'm really getting into that headspace of seeing myself as Miss Supranational and not being ashamed to say I can be the next Miss Supranational, because coming from a very humble background, humility, we were taught to, you know, to say, no, not me, or you would recognize me, I don't have to step out. But humility has so changed for me since entering Miss South Africa. Humility is really understanding that I am being given the privilege to do something great, and therefore I need to fully step into it. If I dumb myself down, I'm not doing it justice. So I'm just going to come in with humility, understanding it could be anyone, but it's me. No.
Your authentic self, in other words. Yes. So are you also doing some dance lessons?
No.
In preparation?
I'm
Why not?
Doing dance lessons. Is it important?
Based on the previous telecast, they always have a lot of dancing involved, whether in pre-pageant or the finals proper. So that's why I asked, have you also been doing dance workshop?
I did see those opening scenes, but I think I can get a hold of it. I can get a routine. If I taught the choreography, I think I'll get into, because I do have a little bit of rhythm. But I cannot dance, but I think I'll rely on my rhythm.
That's nice. You know, that's what I like about you. You can camouflage your weaknesses.
Yes.
That's a spirit. I love your fighting spirit. So, and for sure, you are thriving. You're thriving into this because you seem to love. You seem to love challenges, to take on these challenges head on. And as your country is first Miss Supranational representative because of this organization under the Miss Supranational under Miss South Africa organization banner, does it inspire you to do your best?
Yes, it definitely inspires me to do my best. I actually don't feel too much pressure. I feel like I can do my own thing and set my own standard. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'm so excited. you know, like I said before, I like to be the first to do things. In my family, I am the first doctor. Just to try things, because you never know what you can do unless you try it. So hopefully I do really well for my country, and I'm so happy that I get to represent us first from the Miss South Africa organization.
Yes. You know, it's very challenging how this whole thing, how this thing will work, because, you know, Miss South Africa has been doing both in Miss Super and in Miss World and Miss Universe. So yeah, imagine if you will become the first Miss Supranational from Miss South Africa, from Miss South Africa, or probably place so high in the competition. You never know, right?
It would really be amazing.
Considering that, you know, you've been saying that, okay, you always tend to do this first, this and that, and imagine probably the streak will continue with Miss Supranational, right? So, you know, the tagline of Miss Supranational right now is aspirational, inspirational. For you, what is the definition of aspirational, inspirational?
For me, aspirations automatically bring inspiration along. For example, if I aspire to something, like I'm aspiring to Miss Supranational, automatically those watching me reach for my goals get inspired to aspire for their things. So I feel like they're very much interlinked. You cannot aspire without inspiring. So I feel like they are one thing. And just aspirational is really reaching out for what is within. What, like I said, all of us have an unknown amount of potential within us. And as long as we're alive, it means that we can continue to aspire to greater things. As soon as you're dead, then you're done. But as soon as you're still alive in the world, you can aspire and simultaneously inspire at the same time.
And you know what? I noticed that Miss Supranational is not just, you know, your typical pageant system anymore, because nowadays they also encourage their girls to do their advocacies, you know, to champion causes that are closest to their heart. So for you, what is your advocacy that you are bringing to Miss Supranational?
For me, it has always been education, the power that education can bring, because it has personally brought that for me. But what I'm physically, the advocacy I'm bringing into Miss Supranational is educating children about hygiene. So with the pandemic, we have seen how we have to wash our hands, wear masks, sanitize, but there's some parts of South Africa that don't have access to running water. So I've teamed up with an organization where we're going to teach children how to wash their hands, but also teach communities how to build their own taps in order to have access to that water. So we're just going to bring a lot of water to South Africa and promote that hygiene. But it's also very much in line with my Tuesday talks, which is very much educational. And that's what I'm bringing to Miss Supranational.
You know, we talk about empowerment ever since the start of this interview. And I've always, I get this sense of activism from you, that you not just you want to change something about yourself, but your community in general. Now I want to ask, where is this activism coming from? Their ability your activism to help out people.
I think it's just from the way I was raised, you know. I grew up in a middle class family, but very small town in South Africa. And as little as my parents had, they were always willing to share. You know, you don't need to share when you reach a certain point of success or financial stability or knowledge. You should share with what you have. And I love that from the ground up projects from the Supranational really encourage us to share from your point. Because if you wait for yourself to become a millionaire, by the time you're there, you don't have a giving spirit and a spirit of change. But once you start where you are today, and I want everyone who's listening here to understand that it really starts with your slice of bread feeding one person. Eventually, you can have a factory that feeds people, millions of people on a daily because you've developed that spirit. So for me, I think it comes from that point where my family were giving, were always willing to share and to help from whatever they had, that it just is nature. I feel like the reason each person does not have their own planet on the world is because we need to help each other. We need to bring each other up, you know. Otherwise, we would have each had our own planet, lived alone, and survived. We need each other. And in COVID-19, we need each other even more. So people shouldn't lose that spirit of really wanting to make a difference for other people. And they should not feel discouraged to start based on what they think they don't have.
Nice answer. Nice answer. Yeah. Sharing and your ability to help. Yes, right. So for sure, the organizers of Miss Supranational will really love you to be part of its pageant system with your innate ability to help the people around you. Oh, wow, no words. So let's now go to the second part of the interview. We'll ask you light questions just to get more of your personality.
Okay.
Yes, enough of the serious questions because we know you can talk. You can deliver. At the most crucial time. So let's begin. Describe yourself in 3 words.
Funny, authentic, and goofy.
You know what? I think I'm now getting it. Why they chose you to become Miss Supranational South Africa. Because of that. Your personality. I mean, even if we've gotten to know each other for the past 40 minutes, I feel like, wow, you have such a very engaging personality. And I feel like organizers will really love you for it. Yeah, they really love someone who's very outgoing and engaging.
Thank you so much.
Yes, so yeah, I think you're off to a great start.
Okay.
Are you a morning or night person?
Morning.
What is your favorite hobby? Yeah, me too. Morning. I'm also a morning person. What is your favorite hobby?
Is eating a hobby?
It's a necessity, perhaps. Overeating probably might be a hobby.
No, because I say this because I'm always eating something. I'm always hungry for something. So I don't eat large portions, but you will always find me with food. Because I hate feeling hungry. So I really enjoy that.
What's your comfort food?
Burgers.
Burgers. Wow.
Burgers. Any kind of burger, any beef burger, no chicken burgers, beef burgers.
You can down like a few burgers in one sitting and still look amazing like that?
No, I can't. I get full really quickly, but I do enjoy a good burger. So I'll eat half the burger or the whole burger, but not more than that.
What is one thing that annoys you the most?
Corruption.
Yeah. It's something, I don't know. I guess it's something that is already part of everyone's culture. Yeah. The ability to get ahead.
Yeah, it doesn't have to rule. It doesn't have to consume you, you know?
Yeah.
Mm.
I mean, probably the best way to beat it is if we have a strong sense of faith with God, that everything will, that God will provide for all of us, and that we should always share what we have. Probably. I think it's all about having a strong moral ethic.
Yes, right. I agree with you 100%.
All right. Since we talk about food, what is the strangest thing you have eaten?
Oysters, and I love them.
Really? Oh, did you know that oysters are great aphrodisiacs?
I did know, but that's not why I love them. I do know, yeah. I love oysters, but they are so strange. Every time I eat them, it's like,
Me, I started avoiding eating oysters because it's full of calories.
Really? Okay.
Yes, if you eat too much of it.
Okay. Yeah. I'll watch my
So we talk about, you know, strange things, you know, oysters. What is one of your weird quirks, if you have one?
My weird quirks. Huh. I guess I laugh at awkward times sometimes, just to break the tension.
All right. Like, fair enough. If you could trade lives with anyone for a day, who would it be and why?
With Antonio right now, Miss Supranational, just to see how my life would be and then come back.
Well, but it's so sad she wasn't able to travel a lot.
Yeah.
Because of this pandemic. Yeah. You will really love her. You will really love her once you meet her soon. She's very...
I've already loved her, like, on social media, so I can't wait.
She's very unassuming, very humble. I mean, you would be always stunned by her photo shoots with her glam shots on social media, but once you finally meet her in person, you'll be amazed how beautiful she is also inside. So, yeah, I'm so excited for you. Gosh, I so envy you. You'll be able to meet her. I mean, you'll be able to meet her because I haven't seen her for, like, for more than a year now. Because I met her when I visited Bangkok. So, yeah.
Okay.
And we hit it off well. So, okay. All right. So, what is one thing you hope will never change?
My personality. About me. Yes, my personality. I hope I never change. And I've always hoped it. I've even prayed for it. But it hasn't changed. It's actually hard for me to change. It's hard for me to pretend to be someone else.
Me, I would answer for you my ability to help. I hope that my ability to help other people will never stop so that I'll make more people happy and inspired to do their best in their lives. Oh my God, I felt like I answered a Q&A question. Yeah. Oh my gosh. So we're down to my last few questions. Oh my gosh, I can't believe we're ending my interview very, very soon. What is your favorite movie quote that you tend to live by as you go on in life?
I don't think I live by it, but it's really exciting to watch. It's called Law Abiding Citizen. It's actually my mom and my favorite movie. And it's about how this guy experiences loss. So his daughter, his wife were all murdered in front of him. And he works 10 years to get revenge back at the justice system. And eventually he does get the revenge, but it ends up killing him. So I love
consuming him.
Yes, it shows you that people will hurt you, but don't work so hard to become like them because it will eventually kill you. And it just shows that how an injustice system can really change a person. So I like the dynamics of that. It's really interesting for me, but I won't, for me, it's just like, don't really hold a grudge. Don't hold a grudge.
And my last question, oh my gosh. Oh no, we're down to my one last more. South Africa, fill in the blank. South Africans are good at blank.
pageantry.
Yes, I could agree with that. Yeah. Yeah. Me, I'll answer in speaking in general. I think, you know, once I think, you know, I feel like I've managed to meet the entirety of the population of South Africa with the representatives that you field in pageants, because you guys are all well-spoken, I swear.
Thank you. Right.
And finally, my last question, why should you be the next Miss Supranational?
I should be the next Miss Supranational because I'm simply who I am. I'm authentic. I really aspire to great things, which is the message of Miss Supranational, to be an inspirational but inspirational woman. I'm really good with connecting with people, and I hope that people would connect with me so that we can really tap into various issues, global issues affecting the world. And man, don't you just like me?
for sure. Everyone will adore you once you finally set foot in Poland. Oh my gosh, no words. I've had a great time interacting with you, Tato.
Thank you so
much. I mean, I can finally get it why you were appointed for this title. I finally see
so
it.
Much.
I finally see it. Not just because of your hair, new hair color, but because of your inner self, your ability to engage people. I mean, I think that's the weakness of the Miss Supranational organization.
Oh,
they really love someone who has a great personality, and you really fitted perfectly.
Thank you so much, Adam. I really appreciate you taking your time out on a Sunday to spend time with me.
No words, you know, I love beauty pageants, and all the more I am so enamored interviewing queens like you who are so well-spoken and empowered in their own right. So that last question, can you invite all your supporters, fans, to cheer for you, to root for you for the upcoming Miss Supranational?
I will do that. I will. Hi, guys. Please continue sharing all the love, all the support for me. I really appreciate it. Every comment, even if it's not a comment, a simple prayer, a good luck wish. I really appreciate every single one of you. I love you from the bottom of my heart.
I hope to meet you someday. Gosh.
Hopefully. I really feel like we're going to meet. So, yes.
Yes. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. Sir Werner, if you are watching, thank you for making this possible. I really love Sir Werner, even if I haven't met him. I feel like, you know, I'm so connected with him. Yeah.
He's incredible. He's a genius.
Yet very humble.
Yes.
Yeah. Because I follow him on social media. He's just very caring. He just, he has this ability to overshare.
Yes.
Oh. And he doesn't mind sharing it because, and he always wears his heart on the sleeve. So
honestly,
I really like that. Yeah, I really like that. So there you go. There you go, guys. That ends my interview with the one and only Miss Supranational South Africa 2021, Tato Mosele. I hope you guys had a great time getting to know her. For sure, you will all the more love her once she finally sets foot in Poland. Oh my God, 3 more weeks to go, right? I suddenly became excited about Miss Supranational just by having my interview with you. I mean, you're just
brimming
with personality, yeah.
I am looking forward to this. I feel like it's going to be the best time of my life. I'm just going to be so blown away, yes.
And you know what, before I end, you know, the more I look at you right now, I don't know, you have this semblance with Empu Lake Bilagubi. She's Miss Universe 1999 from Botswana. I mean, there's some resemblance. So definitely she will do well. You will do well.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you are being trained by Sir Werner, for sure, we are in for something huge. Right? So there you go. Thank you so much. No words. I really had a fun time getting to know you, Tato. I hope this won't be the first and last time I'll be able to interview. I will definitely follow your journey in Miss Supranational very, very soon.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you. Stay safe and hydrated. And
hydrated.
Hugs and kisses. Virtual hugs and kisses all
virtual
the way from Manila, Philippines.
Bye.